Hello everyone, this is White Wolf, so if you're coming into the feed, feel free to share out. And also we're going to be doing a message, living by your truth and just standing in it, knowing that it is not opinionated, it is not subjective, it is not reactive, but it's more proactive when you live by your truth and you're dedicated to your truth and you align your vibration to that source of all that there is, the great beyond. And it cuts through the veil, it cuts the tension with a knife, and it gets to the heart of the matter instead of beating around the bush. So when you give truth, when you are receiving truth, it gets right to the heart of the matter. It doesn't cut through all of the BS and allows you to see that when you're living by truth, it is not subjective, it is not opinionated, but it is objective, and it's real, and it's authentic, and it's powerful, and it's empowering when you have this truth and you're living by it, and you're living by the truth of your gift, and you're living by the anointing that's been set before you, and you allow yourself to follow that anointing and follow the breadcrumb trail of excitement to where you can live within the truth and following the things that feel truthful within your life. So when you follow your truth and your ecstasy, recapsulation of energy, and it's understanding that when we're vibrating to the tune of our own drum, to the beat of our own drum, and we're following that source of creation, when we allow ourselves to have something to go on and we have a sense of direction, we can understand that truth always stands. And when we stand in the authority of that said truth and live by it and be dedicated by it and to know that it feels truthful and honest and most vibrationally in alignment with who we are at this exact moment, then how could it be right or wrong? Because there is no right or wrong. You're dissolving the sense of being opinionated. You're dissolving the sense of having to feel like you have to fight for your justice or feel like you have to fight for your goals or your ambition when they're already right here and they're already present. It's just us to accept it. It's just us to receive it. And it's just us to understand who we really are and how far we want to take this, and understanding by living by your truth, you're living by honor and integrity, and you're also just not conforming to how people want you to think, feel, or see, or society wants you to feel, think, and see, and you're erasing everything that tries to hold you back from not tapping into who you really want to be. So you understand that every time you live by your truth, every time you stand in your truth and you put those boundaries and you take off the boundaries off yourself and you take off the limitations off of yourself and you release all of that energy and you let it go and you give up the allegiance of limiting yourself. And it's very empowering because it allows you to see that there's more to this than that meets the eye. It's more than black and white. It's more than right or wrong. It's more than just being opinionated. It's more than just being right. Because feeling justified or feeling right or feeling like we have acceptance. But acceptance, abundance, and manifestation and progression and longevity allows us to live within our truth and own our truth and know that the truth is here to set us free. Because the truth always sets us free, in a sense. So we receive the truth to open ourselves up, and then the truth is set free so that we're able to unleash the truth of God, the truth of the I Am Presence, because it goes past the veil. It resolves the problem. It allows everything to generate an electromagnetic kinetic source frequency, which allows you to be able to tap into every type of frequency of your known aspects, of your known polarities, of your known doppelgangers, your aspects of yourself, the monad, the I Am Presence, allows you to tap into 144,000 of yourselves. In every parallel heightened state, it's allowing us to see that the truth is setting us free and setting us up to open up more ancient gates within ourselves and to open up more gateways and start gates within ourselves that allows us to see that we ourselves are a multiverse of truth, an Akashic record of truth. We understand that we are the ascended master realizing itself, but we are the Akashic record expanding and opening up to more multiverse parallel realities of the absolute reality. So we allow ourselves to be open to such truth, to such divinity, to such power. and not having to use our power, but having to channel our power. Because we feel like a lot of the times that we're using our power, but we're just channeling the power that is present. So whenever we're opening up to more truth, to more vibrancy, we're just opening up ourselves to channel more of the divinity that is present, to channel more of the divine that's within us, to channel more of what we are and what we are not. So if you guys are coming on to the feed, also I will work within your budget. If you want a reading or a healing from me, activations, codes, downloads, you can just personal message me and book a private session. I will work within your budget and we can discuss that. So I don't do live readings anymore because there's too many people on here who are very disgusting and nasty and hateful, and I just don't need that in my life. I've had too many people be very, very nasty to me trying to do live readings and some of that before. So we understand that when we're speaking, when we're vocalizing, there is a frequency within our voice. When we vocalize it, when we sing, when we're dancing, when we're using expression, there is a frequency that is made, that has a lot of different energy waves that allows us to connect within this violet flame light in this bionic 12th dimensional light. The violet flame is 9th dimensional. But whenever we're expressing ourselves, writing something down, vocalizing something, channeling of some kind, it doesn't matter if you're like acting or if you're playing an instrument, all of it is channeling. So it's just channeling the truth that is present and allowing the truth to be laid out at the forefront and allowing it to express your true colors, express who you are, and allow it to be an orchestration of creation, of allowing the interwoven of the divine to keep progressing in this magical painting that you're making within your life. So it could be a collage, it could be a vision board, it could be many different things, but it doesn't have to be one thing. It is not a thing, but it's the source of all things. So it's allowing to understand that this relaxation, the sensation of relaxation, allows us to have sense and sensibility. So when we have sense and sensibility and we allow ourselves to have truth and to be so firm within the truth, to be so honest about our own resistance to the truth wanting to come from us. Because sometimes we want to channel higher energy, we want to manifest higher realities, we want to have better friends, have better business ventures, but sometimes we have to be ready for the truth to be channeled from us. So understanding that sometimes you need to know that maybe right now you're not ready, but maybe in 2 months you'll be ready. Maybe in 6 months you'll be ready. Maybe in a year you'll be ready. But just know that you're right on time and that the bus has not left you. The bus has not left you. The divine has not left you. And it's really cold here. It's like 20 degrees out here. So if you, this can is like super ice cold. So if you've never come on this channel before, this is White Wolf. We're going to be doing a meditation as well. It's an activating meditation. And with this message, I wanted to get on here because I felt like it was a very important before, you know, Christmas and New Year's and stuff like that, that I do a live for you guys to just live by your truth and to stand firm in it and don't waver from your truth. And it's just weaving out all the assumptions and the doubt that comes with having that truth, because you can't have truth and then have doubt or then have something holding you back. So when you have this wall that's in front of you, you have to walk through the wall. You have to break down the barriers itself and realize that that is not who you are, and that's not where you stay, and that's not where your destiny lies with you. It's just allowing ourselves to accept ourselves, to know ourselves, to understand the truth within ourselves allows us to have self control in a sense. Excuse me. So it allows us to have self-control, but it's not being controlling in a manipulative or distorted way. You're like a car that drives itself, and you're able to understand that you can control your life without having to be controlling. So by understanding that you don't have to control your life by being controlling, meaning that you don't have to have control, you don't have to know all of the details, you don't need to know what the outcome is, you don't need to know all of what is going to happen, because all of that doesn't matter, because that's lingering within the future and also lingering within the past. But we're here to be in the present, because that is the most truthful. We allow ourselves to be in the present so that we can understand the truth of the forever now. So in understanding this is that we can understand that we are not a thing, we are not an object, but we are everything in the manifestation of life. That's what we are, is the manifestation of all life, of all sense perceptions, of all illusions that are here and present for us to create and generate out of thin air. So understanding by living by your truth means that living within a reality that fits within your vibration, that fits within how you want to be attractive. And I don't mean on the inside, and I don't even mean on the outside, but to be a magnetic force of abundance. So, but our internal and external need to be perfectly in alignment. But just to be an aura, to just be energy, to just be understanding. So, you don't need to understand. And you will know everything that you need to know when it's the exact moment that it needs to be channeled, and it needs to be learned, and it needs to be honed in. Because just an hour ago, I was watching a movie, and I just almost felt like I just shed another layer of myself. Because I did, I shed another layer and allowed me to obtain another truth, and allowed me to do this message tonight, and allowed me to do this, what I'm doing right now, and speaking in this way, and speaking empowerment and inspiration to this camera right here, because it allowed me to see that the best way to manifest my reality is to know that I've already manifested my reality. The best way to heal is to just lay your heart bare on a silver platter and allow the divine to work on your behalf. The best way to let go is to give up all of your allegiances to all of the negative and distorted vibrations that are present. The greatest thing that you can do for yourself by living by your truth is not wavering in it and just standing firm in that truth and knowing that it is yours to use with great responsibility and great accountability, but also in a way to bring about courageousness, to bring about fearlessness, to bring about freedom to other entities, because they are afraid to use their truth. There are a lot of light workers that are afraid to use their truth. There's a lot of light workers that are not accepted at this time. But I want you to know that you're accepted and that you're loved and that you're divine. And the divine uses its truth to give about that sense of excitement, that sense of obedience, that sense of urgency when we are allowed ourselves to act for ourselves, to think for ourselves, to express for ourselves, and to live for ourselves so that we can live for others. So when we allow ourselves to obtain this truth and allow ourselves to receive this truth, and we allow ourselves to live by our heart and not by our mind, but allow the mind and the body and the spirit to be in sync with itself so that it can realize that it is the soul. It's really cold out here. I won't lie. It's really, really cold out here. So the simple thing about my message is just live by your truth. Live by your resonance. Live by your vibration, and it will never fail you. Live as the god or the goddess that you're meant to be in this life. Don't settle for less. Don't take no for an answer. And if you have things about your life that you don't like, change it. Let go of it. If you have personality traits that you don't like, allow them to be your gifts. If you don't like adversity, face it head on. If you don't like the changing of relationships, learn how to migrate into uncharted waters. If you don't like your job, say, fuck that job. I know that some people are like, ah, I can't wait to quit my job, and I felt that way too. But even if you quit your job tomorrow and you don't do your spiritual work, you can quit that job and get a better job and be more respected and be more valued at a company that loves you and treats you with respect. Respect your vibration, respect your truth. And I think that's real. I think that's very authentic if we just respect ourselves and we treat ourselves as if we were a child. We got to treat ourselves with self-care and self-love so that we can treat others with self-care and self-love and be able to relate to others. And it's not really a point of relating, but you are able to understand what somebody needs, what somebody wants, and what somebody needs to hear instead of what they want to hear. So it's not about what we always want to hear but sometimes just hearing or receiving what we need. And I think at the end of the day, we can be so multidimensional, we can so know so many things and be so gifted and have so many modalities. But at the end of the day, are you, without a shadow of a doubt, living with your truth, with no suffering, with no doubt, with nothing in the way of who you are, or even you being in the way of what you want to become? And if you can say that at the end of the day, that I am living my truth to the fullest of my capability at this exact moment, at this exact present moment, that I am living as the living representation of the higher self manifested in the human body. So just be that higher self and just continue on and don't give up on yourselves. Because once we give up, once we say no to ourselves or disrespect ourselves or put ourselves down or we give up, in a sense, we are losing the narrative and we're losing grip of what we actually are. Because every time that we get to that breaking point, we usher into another state of truth. We usher in another state of reality. We usher into another state where we can persevere and break through and be stronger than we were before. That was my message, but we're going to do a meditation as well before my hands freeze off because it is like 20 degrees out here. It is really, really cold. And I like the energy outside. Like someone said on here, I'm really enjoying your advice. Now, when I'm channeling my higher self, when I go live here, and I'm not being rude, I just wanted to clarify. I'm not necessarily giving you advice because that would be me telling you how to live your life. And I don't want to do that at all. I offer up truth if you resonate with it. If there's something that you don't resonate with it, you can like just crumble it up and throw it in the trash, right? So I'm just giving truth. And if you receive it, if you implement it, that's all up to you. But it's not just like advice, and I'm not here to tell anybody how to live their lives. I'm here to just tell everybody that they are special, that they are gifted, that they are anointed, and that they can be prosperous by using their truth and the art of just channeling that source of creation and that fire and that authenticity at any given moment. So I appreciate that you appreciate that what you think I'm channeling is advice, but really it's just me channeling my higher self. And it's just me laying stuff out on the table for you to receive, or maybe you don't receive it. So I don't want anyone to feel like I'm trying to tell you how to live your life, because that's no. All I do is just channel what the divine wants to channel for me and what message needs to be said. And at the end of the day, I just leave it all out on the table and hope that people receive the meditations and that they get what they need from it. And then they go about their life and they go find something else that allows them to persevere and to grow. So that's what I do. So we're going to do a healing meditation. And probably for the rest of the feed, I'm going to have my hand in my pockets because they are almost like freezing off of my hands. So we're going to do a healing, activating meditation. So with this meditation, focus on an object, lay down, whatever you need to do. Feel comfortable doing this meditation on how you want to do it, and just be free, use your free will, and also just remain calm, collected, and in vibratory nature. Everybody, take a deep breath. Exhale. Allow yourself to have a heart activation from the Palladians. Allow them to use your wisdom as a divine channel, understanding your starseed aspects. Understanding that they have telepathic powers, they can be in a million different places at once, they can move things with their minds, and they're very, very powerful. And there could be a lot of them from the 500th dimension, doesn't matter where they're from. But allow the Palladians to give you a heart activation to where you are able to lead by your heart, to lead by wisdom, to command the channel of your divinity. And when you do this, you'll be able to usher in different states of truth, different states of body, different states of consciousness, different densities of consciousness. So we're receiving from the Palladians, a galactic race. A lot of you are familiar with them, a lot of you work with them. And the spiritual symbolism of the geese, that you're able to work well with others. We actually, my girlfriend saw a flock of geese. So the geese comes to you as reconstruction, rebuilding, being able to manifest better, and also be able to initiate into migrating into who you are. So we're going to have energy from the geese to help us because animals are very psychic. They have many psychic abilities that we do, and they are on a spiritual journey and from different dimensions and different planets as well. And they all have something to tell us. So the geese is about ushering into the new and letting go of the old and just being able to embark on teamwork. If you and your spouse have had trouble, you'll be able to work with them better, or maybe family members. Teamwork, also being able to just progress on the journey, to level up, to have longevity on your journey. So we're going to have the energy from the geese to help us with this meditation as well. Archangel Zadkiel is the angel of protection. So he's going to put a protective flame around us, and he's also going to give us an Egyptian staff. This is a symbolism of power, of protection, Whenever you click this staff on the ground, you are able to teleport into many different places. You're able to put a hedge of protection around you. You're able to call in angels. So with this Egyptian staff, an archangel Zadkiel, to help you with connecting also to his gold and violet flame dragons as well. So we're going to put a flame of protection and use his dragons in this Egyptian staff at any time that we feel in conflict, or we feel like we're having a stressful day, or that maybe we just need to put some boundaries with people, places, and things, and to learn non-attachment as well. So Archangel Zadkiel is going to help us out with that as well. So with this meditation, you can allow yourself to know that living by your truth is living in it, and envisioning it, embodying it, going with it, and observing it, and being cognizant and being aware of the awareness itself. Standing firm in the truth is when you enter into the truth, living by the truth, and not wavering from the truth that you live your life by. Because the truth always sets us free, and truth always stands. At the end of the day, truth always stands, and it's powerful. It's very powerful when you are able to give words of wisdom that give heart healing activations. When you're able to give people meditations to where they're able to receive within themselves, and you're able to allow people to connect. When you're giving off this sense of unity and this sense of aura and the sense of vulnerability and sensitivity, where people are able to connect and understand that we're all interconnected, it's a very beautiful sign that we are miracles, we are the supernatural, we are the divine, we are that magic that is here on the earth to realize and see that. We just need to look closely, listen, and also just be aware that there is magic always going on around us without our knowledge. Some of you are so clairvoyant that you already see that, but some of you needed to hear that. So everybody take a deep breath. Exhale. So by receiving this meditation, by receiving this truth, this emulation of truth, expressing it, and allowing everything to be the progression of consciousness, because when you allow it to be what it really is, and you allow yourself to see past what is actually there, then you're able to get to the heart of the matter, the root cause of any problem. So we're becoming the resolution instead of being a part of the problem. And we are not conforming to what society wants us to be like, what humans want us to be like, what our traditions want us to be like, what religions wants us to be like, but just being ourselves, being an individuated creation, living by our own truth and seeking out what resonates with us and what embody and imbibes us, and not being agree to disagree or being opinionated, but just being obedient to what the divine wants from us. Because it is not a subjective truth. It's not an opinionated truth. But it is a truth that supersedes all biases. So we have to have full acceptance beyond our own personal biases. And just take the limits off of yourself. Push the boundaries. Don't be afraid to be edgy. Don't be afraid to be sincere. And don't be afraid to be honest. It's made you all of what you are inside. And what is inside of me is inside of you. And just live in gratitude that you get to live out this existence. With this divine truth, this essence of source that you get to become, and that nothing will ever be the same. So take one last deep breath. Exhale. When I snap my fingers, you'll come back to, you'll have a greater sense of clarity, you'll know who you are, and you'll become the oracle of love, light, and wisdom, which is God manifested in human form. And so it is. So I want to thank you all for watching this live and a lot of the likes and all that good stuff. So also you can check out my YouTube channel, White Wolf the Oracle, Bloodline Wisdom, BitChute, White Wolf the Oracle. Back. I'm not frozen anymore. Okay. So if you guys would like a reading, healing, activations, just personal message me, book a private session, and just know if you see the messages anytime. That you can receive meditations, that you can receive healing, also just hearing a inspiring message from the divine channel White Wolf, which is I am. And I want to appreciate you guys. I'm going to try to get out of the cold. It is 20 degrees out here, so I would want to thank you guys, and God bless, and namaste. If I learn how to shut this off. Okay, there we go.